Betty's Kitchen. Today we're making pecan cream cheese frosting. And I'm making this specifically to go with my cake that I chose for Easter. And for this year, I'm using an Italian cream cake. So this is just a perfect frosting for that cake, but it's also perfect for, say, a carrot cake or a red velvet cake. You can use it for icing on cupcakes, on cookies, whatever. It's really a utilitarian recipe, but it's pretty fancy too. So let's start over here. I still have my stand mixer out from making the Italian cream cake earlier today. And what I want to do is to put in there one stick of butter. And that's the same as 1/2 cup of butter. And it's room temperature. You can see that it's soft. So that means that we'll be able to blend that really well. I also have out some cream cheese, and this is full fat cream cheese. If you're icing a cake, you probably want the thickness that you get from the full fat cream cheese. I like to use the light or fat-free type for health purposes. I think it is a little healthier, but I don't want a recipe to fail, so I will go with the proper version to get the best results for the recipe. Now also with this, I'm going to add 1 tablespoon of vanilla. So we have vanilla extract, and I've measured out 1 tablespoon that I'm bringing over here and adding in with these two. Now we're going to bring this down and lock it in position, and we're going to turn it to medium, somewhere around there, and blend these together. This will take just a minute. Here's what your mixture will look like, and you'll want to stop and scrape down the sides occasionally, but when it's all smooth like this, you're ready to move on. And the next thing we're going to be adding is powdered sugar or confectioner sugar. Some of you call it icing sugar. And what I really need is just a pound box of it, and I didn't have that here today. I had this 2-pound bag, which I had opened already, but I recall that 1 box or 1 pound of confectioner sugar is the same as 3 3/4 cups. So I just measured it. We're using 3 3/4 cups of confectioner sugar. Now I don't want to put it in all at once, but I'm going to be putting in a little at a time, and then we will turn it to medium and blend it together. And then when we get it all in there, we'll turn it to high and get it blended very finely. I think I'll just prop this back in here. So it'll take me a minute to get it all done, but I think you know the procedure I'm going to do. So we'll show you a nice blended icing in just a second. All right, I think we have it blended very well. So let's bring this up. And you know, a lot of the icing will cling to that. So I'm going to try to dig it off and save as much in there. But it's never a really big problem to have some left over, because there's always someone around here that would like to lick the beaters or the utensil that blends the icing. So this is good enough. We're going to just take the bowl off and come over here. And I have one thing to retrieve. Over here I have some pecans. It came from this package. These are called fancy pecan pieces. They're just chopped pecans, but I have 1 cup in here, and the reason they're in here is that I put them in the oven at 350 degrees for about 5 minutes before I started all of this. And I stirred them a few times during that 5 minutes, and then I took them out and let them cool. They have to be cool. But at this point, they go into our icing. Now, if you don't like pecans, you don't have to put them in. You'll just have a cream cheese frosting. But our frosting here is named Pecan Cream Cheese Frosting, so expect that it has pecans in it. So stir that together, and then once I get it completely combined, we're going to ice a cake. So I'll be back and show you how to ice a cake with this. The cake that we're going to ice with our pecan cream cheese frosting is an Italian cream cake, and it has 3 layers. So I've chosen the best configuration, I think, by putting this layer, which is very flat, on the bottom, and I'm going to cover that with icing. or frosting. And then I think this one will go next because this has a mounted top right there. And I've cooled these. You need these to be cooled completely when you start doing your frosting. So just get a bunch of this in a spoon and put it out in the center if you want to. And then use a spreader or a knife. It doesn't really matter what you use as long as you can make the frosting move. And it should spread like this. It is spreadable in this form. If it is thicker than this or thinner than this, then you may have a problem. But we've got pecans in here, so that raises it up a little bit, but you don't want to overdo it because you need to save some for the sides and for the top. So what my plan is to show you this first layer getting spread. And you can see, I want to come all the way to the edges. It's just a little cantankerous here. But here's what it's gonna look like. And then when I get that to the edges and get it flattened off, something like that. It's not perfect, but we'll go to our next one. And with this being cooled and kind of in the position that I want to use, I'll just lift it up with my hands. And I will actually want to look at it to see if I want to rotate it a little bit or if I have it too far my direction or too far the other direction. It's looking all right. So next comes a layer here of frosting. And then we'll put this on top. And we'll go around the sides and then over the top, and I'll show you a little bit of the last of it, but I think you probably know the process of getting the layers iced. So here we go. Now I've put a generous layer of frosting between the cake layers, and then I've gone all the way around the outside, but I've been very skimpy with that because I wanted to save plenty for the top. You can see this is how much I have left to work with. You can make a bigger recipe if you want to have the really thick icing, but this works out just about right. And you can see I'm sort of finishing up here on the top, and basically all I need to do once I get this little bit covered is to go around and find thin spots, and if I find something that can be improved upon, then I have a little bit to work with and I can add. But once I complete the covering of the top, then I might want to put a decoration on, and I think I will do that and come back to you and show it to you in just a second. So I'll be filling in spots and decorating, and then I'll be back. Here is our finished frosted Italian cream cake.